Thank you. I'm Dina Morley. I'm the CEO of Teleconsult Engineering. I'm also an audiologist and have been for over 30 years. Happy to admit that. Okay, so we've only got a very short amount of time for me to tell you a lot of information. So I'm going to go just as quickly as I can just to give you a quick overview about what is Teleconsult Engineering and what we do. Okay, so we have a hearing impairment program which starts from zero in our early intervention children, and then we have an outpost program. So once they get to school age, we have outposts in 9 schools across Western Australia. This year we opened 2 new ones at Aquinas and John Wollaston, which is fantastic. We also have a speech and language program. We are a registered independent school, and we are the only program for children who have normal hearing but significant speech and language disorder. And so they come to our Wembley campus. We have about 300 enrolled children altogether, but we provide services for about 15,000 children and their families across Western Australia. In our audiology and ear health program, we provide newborn screening in almost all the private birthing hospitals in Western Australia. We also have a large audiology clinic where we provide services for any child in Western Australia, as well as our own enrolled children. We have a cochlear kids program, but we are currently in discussions with Earscience Institute and SENSE about potentially becoming a partner in the Engineers program, which would be more sights for children. We also have Better Hearing TSH, which is, we have an all of life approach for our children, for our hearing impaired children. So they can start with us at zero, and we'll support them right through into that post-secondary space and then on into adulthood. We run some lip reading classes there for adults. That's a advocacy and support service for any hearing impaired person in Western Australia. We also have the PAR Coffee Group, which meet weekly, and that's deaf signing group, which they actually started that, and we supported them to get that off the ground. So that's sort of a social support group. Linda Lexis is here, can tell you more about all of Better Hearing TSH. We also do a lot of research. We don't do any ourselves, but we have a research officer, and we partner with quite a number of universities. I think at this point in time, we've got about 19 research projects that we're doing. So that's just a little bit snapshot. So with our hearing impaired early intervention program, it is a multidisciplinary approach that we take. So families or children get services from auditory verbal therapists, speech pathologists, psychologists and occupational therapists and our audiology team. So they all work together to have the best outcomes possible for the children. Jodie Coleman's here if you want more information about early intervention services. As I said before, our outpost is our school support program, and we're very proud that we've got these 2 extra schools this year, so that's where the schools are. It's a system where we have teachers of the deaf, education assistants and note takers, and the children are mainstream, but we withdraw them depending on their needs. So all of our programs focus on the needs of the children and working with the families together to provide the best outcomes for the children. So some children might be withdrawn every day, some children might be withdrawn once a week, some children might just need note taker services. Our outpost program is also multidisciplinary, so we always, in all of our services, focus on the emotional well-being of the children and the families, as well as their speech and language development and their educational attainment. Talk about is our program for children who've got normal hearing but speech and language delay or disorder. I think for some of those families that's even more challenging than having a hearing loss, because most of our families there's no diagnosis of why the child isn't speaking, and so that can be quite challenging. And for the parents in the audience, at least if you know why something's happening, you can actually know what to do about it. But our program has some remarkable outcomes for our children, and I believe it's the only one of its kind. I think I've talked enough about audiology and ear health. We also have a large program that we run across quite a bit of Western Australia, providing ear health services for mainly Aboriginal children, and our research has shown that the program that we've been running in the metropolitan area has significantly reduced the incidence of middle ear disease. Down to about what you'd find in the normal population for that same age. So we're very proud of that, and we're going to keep working hard on that one. Talked about better hearing to say it's ready. Belinda Alexis is here if you want any more information about that. You can always come and visit us as well. I just wanted to say a couple of things from notes I've taken, if that's okay. We do meet with SENS once a term. We've worked quite closely with SENS, and we're very proud of that partnership, and we're doing some good things together. Also, I just wanted to touch on the social inclusion that was raised earlier. Just to let you know that we partnered in a 3-year study looking at social inclusion amongst children who enrolled in centres like ours around Australia and New Zealand. There's about 300 children in that study. There was a big Australian study looking at social inclusion for all Australian children, and we were comparing our children's results to the general Australian population for children. And for our 6 centres, we found that they were either equal to or above average in their social inclusion. So we were really excited about that, and we're now analysing what it is that we're doing that makes that difference, because I agree with everything you said earlier. Just a couple of new things we're doing. We've just opened a private speech pathology clinic because we had lots of people wanting speech services, and we're just in the process of looking at opening a private sight clinic for deaf and hearing impaired people, because our psychologist feels that that's a service that's not available in Western Australia. And I'll stop there. Thank you very much.